Morning students, here I am presenting you the topic vase. As we see here, W-A-G-E. In general words, we can always pronounce this word or use this word for some type of labor reward or in money reward. But in economics, as we add in S in this, as in this, it becomes wages. So now the term wage is used in a wider sense in economics, the payment made to the physical as well as mental service for the related human beings are known as a wages in economic theory. Yes, whenever we use the term ways, we can talk about only the money, only in rupees, in some type of paisa, kuch bhi aap paise mein de rahe hain unki mazdoori ke badle. And when we talking about the wages in economics, the wages term uses the labor of mental or physical and give the reward in any manner. Any manners means to facilitate some things, buy some things, or by money. So here the two types of wages is money wage and the real wage. In money wage is concerned only with the monetary things or only by money. केवल ओनली मनी से रिलेटेड जो होता है दैट इज कम्स टू द मनी वेज. बट इन रियल वेज वी कैन इंक्लूड्स यस ऑल द रिवॉर्ड्स फॉर लेबर और वर्क. अंडरस्टूड. बट इन रियल वेज वी इंक्लूड्स मनी as well as all the facilitation services, facilities given by the entrepreneurial or by the management. So we can say that wages can be divided into two parts, that is a money wage and a real wage. And real wage includes all the rewards which is received in the money as well as the facilitation services, discounts, etc., etc. Obviously, whenever some labor or any human being sell their physical or mental labor, only that point of time he or she will receive the wage for their services. The independent workers such as professional, doctors, lawyers, etc., who charges fee for their services is also includes in a wages. Businessmen and managers who look after their own business, he also paid by very handsomely by their wages. And we can divide the wages into two parts. Again and again I am saying into two parts only, money wage and real wage. In money wage implies the wages paid in the term of money. In the term of money only, the payment made to worker for him labor in liquid or monetary form is called money wages. It is not capable of measuring the economic position of a person. By money wage, you cannot measure the economic position of a person, and its measurement is done on the basis of real wage. इसका जो measurement होता है वो real wages के basis पर ही होता है. The nominal wage, however, does not give us an indication of the real economic position of a worker. To have an idea of his real economic condition, we have to find out his real wages. The real wage refers to those advantages, consequences, concessions, facilities which are provided to our workers in addition to his nominal wage. Come to the point that money wage we can calculate in a nominal term too. That's why it is also called as a, इसको हम nominal wage भी कहते हैं. Because only in money form we can calculate the labor easily. We can't calculate the real wage so easily as we can calculate the real wage. कितना भी छोटे से छोटा amount होगा किसी की services का, हम उसको पैसे में दे सकते हैं. 10 rupees, 100 rupees, but 100 rupees का services क्या देंगे उसको? So we cannot measure these things. So that's why money wage is called as a nominal wage too. So understand? And in real wages implies the employed the goods and services that a person can obtain from his nominal wage. The purchasing power of money wages is called the real wages. It also include the amount of such goods and services and other benefits which a person gets over above the money wages, such as free medical benefits, free or cheaper electricity, free or subsidized house, etc. Yes, come here. Real wages that include all the services and rewards. We discussed that all the services and rewards, it includes all the concessions, fee rebate, discounts, subsidies, cheaper services, etc. In this, all the concessions, fee rebates, discounts, subsidies, and cheaper services, etc. means whenever an employee hiring for some job, he decided or the management decided their salary. In salary, all the nominal wages and real wages are included and decided their wages or their salary. So in money wage, we can decide that there are segments of employees in organizations who decided their ABC segment. A, B, C, D. है ना? अब all the four stages, the wages level will be different. On their money wages basis, the real wages will be decided. If A category employee got 10,000 rupees, B is 8, C is 6, and D is 4. So according to their money wages or nominal wages, the real wages advantages or facilities will be decided by the organizations. On like for example, for the A category employee will get high concessions, high benefits, high discounts, high subsidies and cheaper services, etc. Understand? Now there are the some definitions of real wages. The reward and debt given must be taken to apply not only the necessaries and convenience that and directly provided by the employer for the purchase of labor or product, for must be taken also advantages which are attended or attached to the occupation and which require to special outlay on his power. It is according to the Marshall, as he says that real wage refers to net advantages of the workers' occupations. Net advantages means all inclusive in debt money wage. Advantages, debt is the amount of necessaries, comfort and assurance of life which the worker can demand or command in return of his services and labor. In real ways, the worker or the human being can demand their real wage services and And here are the some determination factors or determining factors of real wage. In this, first one is extra earning, extra facilities, nature of work, work condition. In this is the most important thing is work condition. If a worker is satisfied with their work conditions, situations, he is mostly satisfied with their aura or the situation or the environment of work, that time the real wage will be can be down or can be less. But vice versa, but even when the situation or environment is not suitable for the workers and he is dislike the environment of the work, he demand for the real wage to increase. Regulatory of work, in this permanent employees incentives will be high as compared to a new or temporary employee. Yes, it is very much clear that always the permanent employees gets more and more subsidies, facilities and real wages rather than the temporary or the new employees. Occupational expenses, it is by the employee only. It is monetary term. Training period and its costs, comparatively low as per demand. In some professions, training is must for undertaking the job, property, such as the work of a doctor or an engineer. In such cases, the real wages are considered to be lower compared to the job. No such training is required. For the real wages, there are no such training of required to compensate their workers for their labors too. Now, next is future prospects of promotions. If an employee sees their future prospects in the future, their work capacity and the ability will increase day by day and they work hard and harder to get the promotion and to get the increased real wage in the future. In this, real wage will be high as compared to the salary. Yes, sometimes it may increase than their salary which already he or she is receiving from the organization, because at this moment the employee is highly motivated to do the work to get the promotion in the future sense, in the future. So he or she are doing their hard and harder worker and give their best effort to the organizations to their complete the task. Then last one is the social status. The social status of the employee is not only the real factor of to decide the wages of that particular employee, it is a purchasing power or standard of living. We see, for example, we can see that somewhere that one part A employee is earning less than a B employee, but the living standard is much higher than the B. So it cannot be decided, but the social status be deciding factor of real wages, ki how to maintain their employees to facilitate win by their real wages. So students, hopefully you understand the today's topic, wages, most clearly. Thank you so much.